What's up, guys? Welcome back to the YouTube channel. So before we jump into what we're going to be talking about today, I want to start off by saying welcome to those of you that may be new to the channel. And for those of you that stay amped, welcome back. And thank you so much to you guys for, you know, watching my videos. Jumping into what we're going to be talking about today is we're going to be talking about the Supro Keeley Custom 12. This bad boy right here. And just a little bit about this amp, a little bit about how I got this amp. So before I had this amp, I was using a Vox AC15 tube amp, and I ended up selling that one to my friend. And then I was in search for an amp, and one of the biggest things that I was searching for in an amp was that it take pedals pretty well. And this amp does a really great job of taking pedals really well. It has enough headroom for the amp to be as clean as possible, and the amp also gets pretty dirty as well. And what I mean by that is that it gets, you can get it to get crunch, get gritty, get overdrive, whatever you want to call it. But this amp gets pretty loud and dirty if you take it there. And it does have a effects loop. It has a send and return, which I haven't really taken too much advantage of. I normally just plug in directly. And just to show you guys how clean it sounds, I'm not running any effects into the amp at the moment. I'll show you guys later on how the amp takes pedals, and right now I'm gonna show you guys exactly how it sounds, just clean, straight clean. This is what I mean by how the amp gets a little bit dirty. You get it dirty right here. Let me turn that down just a little bit. It's pretty dirty. It's a tube amp as well. And one of the most important things for me personally, the fact that I use effect pedals, you know, modulation, it was important for me to find an amp that took pedals really good. And to be honest, I have nothing negative to say about this amp. It does have a Celestion Creamback speaker. I believe the Vox AC15 had a Celestion Greenback speaker. And personally to me, I feel like the Celestion Greenback speaker was just a little bit bright. And the Creamback speaker is definitely a little bit more warmer. And that's kind of the tone that I was really searching for. So, I mean, it just... Even clean, just it sounds so good.
Thank you.
Let's throw some Big Sky on there. Let's see how it sounds. Let me show you guys how that sounds. And, yeah, one of the things that I mentioned before, I always have my Jackson Audio Bloom compressor running. I always leave that on. But, yeah, I threw in some Cloud, which is my favorite preset off the Big Sky, and this is how the amp takes it. It just takes pedals so good, and you have enough headroom to get that cleanness out of the amp, and like I said, you have enough volume on this amp and juice to juice it up and just get that grit out of it. But yeah, guys, let me go ahead and just show you a little bit about how this amp looks, just different angles of the amp, and then I'll show you how it sounds running delay, overdrive, and reverb. So yeah, let's get into it, guys. Thank you.